Hey, good morning, Emmanuel family. I wanted to take a moment and just visit with you and try to share with you our plan and our hearts as a church staff. I hope you'll give me a few minutes. We're also going to email this out and share it online. And so I hope you'll take a minute to connect. First of all, we want to talk about getting through this together. And the first thing I want to say is we will get through this, and you will too. I don't know how and how it's going to unfold. We are in a day where the information is changing daily, and yet we know God, and our faith holds, and He holds us, and He is the author and finisher of our faith. And so, like I said Sunday, Jesus is not afraid, and I follow Him, and I know you do too. So we know He's not surprised by any of these things, and this is His church, we are His church, and He will sustain us. He knows how to. I do want to say, if you become aware of any critical need in our church family, or if you have one, please contact the church office. Email us, Facebook message us, text us, somehow reach out and connect with us so we can serve those needs. And I want to ask you today to follow a basic rule. And it goes like this. If God's Spirit places somebody on my heart, I will reach out personally to see how they're doing. If our whole church family would do that, this would be an enormous and a wonderful time of connectivity and encouragement. If God's Spirit places somebody on my heart, I'm going to reach out personally and see how they're doing. The second thing I want to say is we'll stay on mission. What do I mean by that? Our mission is to share the gospel and to grow devoted followers of Jesus Christ. Our purpose is to love and to grow and to serve. And this time, we're going to be able to just press forward and see those purposes fulfilled differently and in a broader way. And I'm really excited about the opportunity that God has before us. There's fearful hearts all around us, and it's time for us to step up with joy and with hope and with encouragement and with the gospel. The third thing I want to say is we will celebrate together really soon. I don't know how long we won't be able to assemble. And yet we are going to assemble online, and we're going to do everything we can do to stay connected. And you've already done an incredible job at that, and we want to encourage you to continue that in the days ahead. But we're planning a phenomenal celebration Sunday. Until we can reassemble, please just assume that our gathering activities are postponed right now for the moment. And so Sunday morning we'll be live streaming, Wednesday night we'll be live streaming, and our other activities and events are just on hold for the moment. The other thing we will be doing is having a small gathering every Saturday morning for the men to come and pray. And I encourage you, if you're a little concerned about gathering for that, then live stream in on that as well. We'll Facebook Live that and do other things. But we do want to make this a time of prayer as a church family. The next thing I want to say is we will do everything we can to stay connected online. A lot of great things are unfolding for us. First of all, you can find us at the church website, ebcnewington.com. And when you click on the live stream or scroll down the page a little bit, you'll see the videos. Anytime we go live, those videos will be there and they'll be archived there. Also on Facebook, you'll be able to go to EBC Newington and you'll find our Facebook page, and that's where we'll be keeping things updated. And then I'm really excited about this. We are going to start coming to you for a brief time every day. We're developing a website and an outlet that we're calling Enough for Today. This is based on the words of Jesus in Matthew 6. Take therefore no thought for the morrow shall take thought of the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. And Jesus also taught us to pray earlier in that chapter, give us this day our daily bread. And I know you've got a lot of information coming at you from every direction. Our desire as a staff is to speak to three groups in our church family, adults, teens, and kids, and really on a daily basis through Enough for Today. We will be coming to the adults via our live stream and our webpage and YouTube and Facebook Live. So any of those outlets at noon every day, right in the middle of your day at your lunch break, you can jump online and maybe 10 to 15 minutes we will have a word of encouragement for you, either me or one of our pastoral staff. Pastor Lance will be doing the same for the teenagers, and Pastor Sherwin will be doing the same for the kids. And we're going to build all of these into an archive on enoughfortoday.church. So we'll give you more information about that later. But we are doing everything we can to stay connected through live stream and encourage you. Also, our groups will stay connected online. Your group leader will send you a link to a Google Hangout or some other format by which you can gather as a group and hear a lesson and encourage one another, share some prayer requests. And if you don't have a group, email Pastor Derek and we'll get you engaged in a group. We'll be excited to do that. So we will be live streaming every Sunday morning at 10 a.m. and the video will then be archived and share these things, by the way. This is a tremendous time for outreach. And we had thousands of people that engaged with us on Sunday, both during the live stream and then after in the next 24-hour period. Every Sunday morning at 10 a.m., every Wednesday evening at 7 p.m., you can jump on live stream and hear a Bible lesson. Sunday morning will be a full worship service. And then every day for 10 to 15 minutes at the noon hour, enough for today. Next, we'll continue to respond. So phones, emails, messages. If you know of a need, please know that your church staff is engaged. We are calling through the church directory today and the next few days, really, to make a master prayer list of how has this trial most significantly impacted you. And we want to support and strengthen and pray for you as much as possible. Next, we will keep you informed on very specific needs and opportunities that we can serve as a church family. And I know God will lead us. We may come to a point where we're literally helping members and families in our church with basic necessities, basic needs. And I know that God will provide. I know that we'll hear him and we'll follow his leading in these ways in loving and caring for one another. We're already praying that God will protect you, your job, your basic needs. But, you know, we're in this together and we're going to love each other and help each other through it. And we will also keep you informed as to our ministry financial picture. Of course, we're going to operate as fiscally careful and conservative as possible. But there will be at a time like this, those who have more and those who have less. And we want to keep the whole church family, the broader church body, informed as to the needs, both individually and corporately as a church and school. We will help you connect. And this is really important. If you or someone you know doesn't really know how to get connected to either the live stream or the regular email updates or Facebook or online giving or any of those types of things, we have some great men in our church that will come to your home and help you connect these things. Maybe you just want to get the live stream from your phone or iPad or computer up onto your television. We can help you do these things, and we would be honored to do that. So let us know at the church office. We'll have somebody come by and get you connected. Almost done. I want to say next, we are in this together. I really believe that our church will thrive during this time. I'm excited to see how God's going to show himself real and prove and validate our faith and provide for our needs. I believe our church will grow both spiritually and numerically. I believe that our faith is really going to be strengthened right now, and we're going to be amazed at what God does, even as we've been amazed in the last years. When you begin to fear, remember this, you're not alone. Everybody has the same kinds of concerns right now, and we're all in this together. Everybody's facing basically the same set of circumstances, and we'll get through this together. Next, I want to say we are hope in a fearful world. Tozer said this, a fearful world needs a fearless church. We have hope. Most people around us do not and don't have any sense of the hope that we have that strongly holds us together. And more than ever, people around us, their hearts are soft, their psyches are fragile, they're fearful, they're worried. You know, many will fall into despair in the coming days. Many will take their own lives. Some people will consider in the coming weeks taking their own lives. They'll feel so financially ruined, they'll feel so destitute and alone that they won't see a way out. And God might position you close to those people or people like that. And I really want to encourage you to offer the antidote to fear. That is the gospel of Jesus. And I want to strengthen you in this. You know the gospel. You've heard me preach it thousands of times. And now it's your turn to preach it, okay? To share it with those within your reach. And now it's time to be the church. God's Spirit is going to empower you and give you the will and the opportunity and the ability to speak. So don't fear. Don't worry about having answers to questions you don't have answers to. You don't have to have all the answers. You have to have a gospel message. That's why God has left us on this planet. So today, reach out to your coworkers, your neighbors, your family, your friends, and give them an offer them an explanation of hope, of the hope that is within you. I promise you, many of them are eager to listen right now. Hey, listen, we live by faith. This is a critical moment, and every single response of our hearts is either going to be a statement of faith or a statement of fear. Our hearts, of course, are tempted to shrink in fear, but God calls us forward in faith. There are a lot of things I don't know and I cannot control, a lot of mystery to what's unfolding right now, but here's the things that I know and that are within my ability to control and yours as well. I will, okay, this is my resolve. These are my decisions. I will wake up tomorrow and worship my God. I will open His Word and I will walk with Him personally. I will rejoice in this day because this is the day that the Lord has made. And I'm gonna rejoice and be glad in it. I will love my family and bless those that are within my reach. I will serve Jesus and honor Him throughout the day. Hey, cancer might take me down, some other illness might take me down, a financial ruin might take me down, but I can promise you this, I'm gonna love and serve Jesus Christ as long as I'm on this planet, as long as I have breath. Next, I will share the gospel with anyone that I can. Anyone that'll give me a hearing, I will offer them the hope of Christ. Next, I will continue to honor my God through faithful giving and generosity. I've told you this personally, as for me and my house, everything that God gives to us, we'll honor Him with the first fruits. Next, I will fear not and refuse to worry about tomorrow. Again, Jesus said, take no thought for the morrow. Sufficient unto the day. Today's problems are enough. So God, give me this day my daily bread. And I'm not going to be afraid or worried about tomorrow. Next, I will encourage my church family to do these same things. And so I encourage you to make your own list of I wills. Hey, you cannot know tomorrow. You cannot control these circumstances, but you can do some very specific things. Hey, listen, we are Jesus's church. His church has always been resilient. Always. The local church of Jesus Christ has always been resilient. So rise up, church family, and live in faith and rejoice in hope and magnify Jesus together and show Him to others and love one another. I have always had total confidence in the strength of the faith of our church family. But now we actually get to display it more brilliantly, more loudly, more brightly and vibrantly than ever before. Remember this, if God's Spirit places somebody on my heart, a church family member, a team member, a group member, a recent guest, a friend, a neighbor, a coworker, if God's Spirit places someone on my heart, I'm going to reach out personally and see how they're doing. And remember this, Psalm 118:24, this is the day the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. I love you, and I'm praying for you, and I am trusting God that we will get through this together.